All right, Joy. So the market mover today is definitely about the uncertainty surrounding the economy. The final jobs report of 2018 was just released this morning, and it was a big one. Joining us to break down what this all means and the numbers, financial planner Matt Roddy of Rockland Trust. So, Matt, I mean, this is a big number. We're talking 316,000?
312,000.
Yeah. Yep. So that's huge. That's a lot bigger than people expected.
Yeah, it's right? A huge increase over the expected, which is around 180,000. They actually also revised November as well as October up by about 50 or 60,000. Certainly a number that I candidly wasn't expecting to be so far. I don't think anybody else was, clearly. The other thing is participation went up, so more workers are entering the workforce, which kind of makes the unemployment number look weird because it goes up even though so many new workers are in there. But it's actually a good sign to see that as well. So and the wages, too, were strong. 3.2%, that's the highest wage growth we've seen in a long time. All things, it was a good timing, though. The market's been really focusing on negatives and pessimism. So this was a really good timing to get a good report to kind of stop that in its tracks as some of the negative stuff was starting to persevere.
So do you think the markets will react positively today? And then, you know, for folks who have investments in stocks and other things, it's like, hold on. It might be okay after all.
Yeah, no, I think that's exactly right. I think the markets are reacting pretty well. It's sort of a mixed blessing type of news. It's so strong that it puts the Fed rate hikes that everyone's been fearing back into the, you know, to spotlight. It certainly would warrant that the Fed probably has a license to raise rates a couple times next year. But at the same time, it's also something I think we're going to focus on today and worry about that tomorrow. And I think we'll have a decent day on the back of this news just because it is so good. I mean, you know, the consumer makes up two-thirds of the economy. They're employed, they're rising their wages, and they're doing well. So I think that's important to take note of.
I got to ask you, too, because this time of year, obviously, holidays and holiday jobs kind of factor into it. How much do you think that factored into this number, and do you see
not a heck of a lot. I mean, honestly, the holidays, you know, these numbers are taken pre-holiday. And actually, the other thing interesting to note is that it was pre the government shutdown. So it might be a little bit strong. There might be a little bit of noise from that. But I think the interesting thing to note today is the three Fed chairs are meeting today at 10:15. I would tell everyone that could be a very interesting conference as they speak, because you've got one who pulled Bernanke pulled the patient out of the fire. Mm-hmm. And then you had Janet Yellen, who nursed that patient back to health. And now Jerome Powell is really in charge of getting that patient up and running and fully going. And, you know, he's doing a pretty good job, but I think some people are concerned about the rate hikes and what they'll do to the patient.
And the patient, of course, being the economy. Thanks so much, Matt Roddy, for joining us this morning from Rockland Trust. Joy, back over to you.